Okay, here we are, November 1st. Where is this year going? Wow. Anyway, just wanted to give you a quick update for the month that just passed, October. Nothing much exciting going on here. Really have been limited in travel, so I haven't been to a fish store. Got my final hip replacement done October 7th. And the recovery has been slow but steady. And so it's now November 1st, so that's what, 3 weeks? And then a little bit, and I'm walking with a cane, but I'm not driving yet, and so our travels have been limited to the food store and to physical therapy in the first of several out weeks of physical therapy. And so it's coming along, and I thank you for your concern and regards. And so I'm sitting here enjoying the tanks, and I'll tell you, it's been a little bit work has really been done more by my wife than I, although today I did clean up these tanks just a little bit. As you'll see, the office tank that she cleaned up before, and I think I got an image of it before it overgrown it again. And in the past 3 weeks, it's just totally filled up, which makes for a great maternity tank, as you will see. But for right now, here's the corner tank, and the fish are doing very well, not losing any. The angelfish that we got for here, the four small angelfish, are doing very well. You see them right in the front there. And they're not growing up very big, but they certainly look pretty as they are. And they tend to hang out three together and a fourth one by itself for some reason or other. So you'll see up in the upper left-hand corner, there's one. Down the center, there's two. Upper right-hand corner, which you probably can't see, is a third. And where's the fourth? I don't know. Anyway. Oh, there's the fourth one. They're all three over in the left-hand corner, like I said. The plants are doing well. Those plants that I got from Disc Madness way back when, that I still don't know what kind of plants they are, continue to thrive in all three tanks. And so that was a great investment of like $9 for nine sprigs that have never stopped since. A lot of space in the top of this tank now that I've replanted some of those plants. And off in the right-hand corner here, you can see the Madagascar lace plant coming back slowly but surely, just like my hip replacement is going. And I'm very pleased with that. This Amazon sword, not Amazon sword, my Madagascar lace plant has been around a long time. And it's gone through some cycles where the leaves get really big and wide, and then they come back narrow, and they're sort of in the middle right now. The other plant that was here last time you saw this tank was that lime green, and the only thing that's left of that is right there. It's totally gone. There's probably a bulb down in the gravel someplace that will bring it back at some point in time, I'm sure. And I'm trying a tripod here that's not very, it's a cheap tripod, and it's not giving me the smooth motion that I need, so I'm sorry about the jerkiness here. Nothing special here. It just amazed me that the swordtails continue to do so well. Again, I went through a couple of years where I couldn't even find swordtails. And I like a swordtail. It's a great looking fish. And these are mostly our babies grown up, especially the brick red swordtails that you see here. There's a black wag sword in there. And they keep just reproducing themselves. And so while there's probably a good dozen full-size ones here, the bow tank you'll see has a number of them also. And I have moved. You remember the last time we talked, I had the two big females that were obviously ready to drop their babies moved into what I call the maternity tank, that small betta tank. And they did not drop those babies. So I finally, after like 2 or 3 weeks, said, oh, the heck with it, I'll move them back into this tank. And I did, and again, they just sat there so big, ready to drop, I thought, that I finally said, oh, what the heck, I'll go put them in the office tank, which has a lot of growth in it, and so the babies thrive there. So you may see them in the office tank video, although the growth is so thick right now that you don't see anything in there, unless it comes to the very front glass. And so what I'm hoping to do is make these videos and then take some time and clean out that office tank, take all the plants out. This is something Bruce taught me. I used to just work around the plants there, but he takes all the plants out and redoes it. And I said, you know what? That makes a lot of sense. And so the last couple of times I've done it, and Pam has no compunction with doing that at all, I'll take all the plants out, group the bunch plants, and maybe move them into what is now a lesser grown bow tank that you'll see in just a minute. They go through cycles. And so, for example, there's no kabamba in this corner tank right now. It just totally disappeared over time. And if you go back a year or so ago, this was overgrown with kabamba. So obviously something changes with the chemistry, and the net result is you have different situations going on. The black mollies are continuing to just do okay in here. There's a couple of baby black mollies, so somebody's dropped babies, and they haven't been eaten by either the red-tailed sharks or the tricolored sharks or any of these other fish, so that's good. Not enough to repopulate anything, just to see once in a while some babies. And the office tank has a lot of black molly babies. So that is repopulating itself. And as I've said before, I had a time where the black mollies were doing great in here. A good dozen or more large black mollies, and then over like 6 months, they all disappear. Don't find a dead body anyplace. Just all of a sudden you realize, wait a minute, I don't see any black mollies. And so you see the red-tailed sharks going off there to the left, where that was a tricolored shark being chased by a red-tailed shark. The two red-tailed sharks in here are huge. They're doing very well, and I guess one of the things I've heard, there comes one out of the left-hand corner, just one across the front, and the other one is just to the left there. I'm trying not to move the camera because I don't have a smooth moving camera right now, but he's just coming out of the Amazon sword area there, the Vallisneria area, and you can see how big he is. Beautiful looking fish. But I did hear someplace recently where they complained that they get really big. And for this tank, they're a good size, that's for sure. But they're a beautiful fish and I love them dearly. So here's an overhead view of that beautiful Amazon sword that fills up this whole tank. There's those angels I was telling you about. The angels tend to follow me around as I just move from one side to the other. The big pleco in the back here that comes out, and I don't know what to do about him. He's keeping this glass pretty clear. I ought to move him over to the bow tank because that needs to be taken care of. But I don't know if you can see him in the back, but there's three of those Otacillus catfish. They do a pretty good job of keeping the algae down, and there's one over here in the left. I don't know if you can see it or not. So anyway, this is the corner tank, and let's move you over to the bow tank. Okay, here's the bow tank. Both of them are about 55 gallons, as I've said many times before, but for new viewers. And again, I really enjoy the comments people make here. I thank you very much. I'm trying to make sure I reply to all those comments. And I'm not zooming in too much on these tanks today for no special reason, just like I said, the tripod is not allowing it to have the usual smooth movement, so I'm going to throw this tripod away. But you can see in the center, that's that tank, that's that plant, green and reddish brown leaves that I got. That size of the plant is what I saw in the Disc Madness main plant tank. And when I admired it, you recall, I said, you know, can you buy it? Oh, yeah, sure. And I said, all right, I'd like some of it. And they just clipped off like 7 or 8 branches of it, not big branches. And I thought, oh, I got taken. But the thing is, never quit. So I take back my complaint. And this plant that you see there right now is about the size of what was in that tank. The only thing in the tank was that plant, that center plant. And I looked at it, I was so admiring it. I said, you know, would you sell that plant? And he said, yeah, we would. Obviously it was their source plant for selling subplants. And I figured it would be worth about $100. And I said, what would you sell it for? And he looked at it and he calculated, he said, $99. I wasn't going to buy it because it would take up a whole tank. But it really, that's the size of the plant right there. You see off to the left in the back, maybe I can zoom in on that without messing around here. Whoops. You can see the neons in the back there doing well. And black mollies, probably about 6 or 8 black mollies here. All babies have grown up. And there's those Davidson barbs, the two of them right there in the front. Well, if I go down, you'll see them. There we go. They continue to grow and be very beautiful fish. I really am pleased that I ventured out and spent more money than I normally do for fish that time that I found them. And you see the red-tailed shark right there in the center? He's the biggest of the four of them at this point. And if we're patient, maybe the other one will come out too. They tend to chase each other. And the pearl gouramis that you see right down in the center front are starting to get as big as the one that was in there before I added those three from the corner tank here. There's two or three really small pearl gouramis that aren't growing up at all in the corner tank. And I don't know what that's about, but hey, they're miniature pearl gouramis. What can I say? You can see the angelfish doing equally well. And again, I'll just try and move this slowly. They've been laying eggs on the leaves of the Amazon sword plants, and they chase every other fish out of that corner of the tank where they are to the left right now. And those two that you see in the back left-hand corner, they've got like an orange and a black mixture on them. That's the mating pair, and they don't do anything except guard those eggs, and about 2 or 3 days later the eggs are all gone again. And they've done it twice in the past 2 weeks, much to my wife's thrill. There's the red-tailed shark. I don't know if that's the same one or the other one. It looks a little bit smaller. Maybe it's the other one. And so those two angels, when they're in the mood, right, they'll keep all the rest of the fish over in this corner to the right. And then that one, the one yellowish angel there, just facing the tank, facing the camera right now, he doesn't leave those other two alone. He just goes after them, and it's almost like he's challenging the male to be a mate. Not that he ever succeeds, but certainly makes for some interesting fishing. So, again, not having gone out, there's nothing new here. Oh, look at that. There's the clown loach right in the center. Doesn't usually come out, but I'm far enough away that he's not being spooked. Oh, I'm sorry for jerking around like this. Oh, sure. Right. Show us your tail, silly. Turn around. There you go. You can see how pretty he is. This pair were in the office tank, and when I was having snail problems out here, I moved them out, one in each of the two tanks. And so there's one in each, and they are doing very well by themselves. I know they like to be in schools, and I like them when they're together. And I did extensively go searching for some replacements. And a couple months back, I showed you the four that I found, which were a ridiculous price. I mean, like $12.99, and they were small clown loaches. And I put them in the office tank. And over a period of about 3 weeks, they all died. So major loss there, but I was afraid to move them out into these tanks because of the bigger fish here. And at the same time, I've had problem with ick out in these tanks in the past, not recently, nothing recent. So maybe I could have got away with it, maybe I couldn't, I don't know. So meanwhile, these are the two living room tanks, and they're doing quite well at this point, and plant-wise, when I take all the plants out of the office tank, especially the kabamba, I'll move some of it out here and see if... You see over in the left-hand corner, remember the kabamba that was there last time we viewed this tank? It's not there. It's totally gone. I didn't take it out. It didn't break up into pieces. It just Probably was eaten up by the fish more than anything else. So meanwhile, let's go see the betta real quick and see if we can get a picture of him before we go back into the office. I think they're going to be fed, but I'm too busy with the camera right now to do that. But there's that mated pair right here. And of course, the neons are in the background. Here's that betta tank, and like I said, the one betta in here, and three neons and an Otacillus catfish. But that betta is so beautiful. A tan fin with brown trim on it. Catching it really nice in the light right now. I'll try and zoom in without using the tripod here. Sorry for the movement. Look at those fins, aren't they beautiful? All right, I'm gonna stop moving around. The hips are not helping me any right now, even though I'm standing holding this thing in the air. This is the office tank as it currently exists. And I wish I could show you the nice arrangements that Pam made when she cleaned this up for us. But in the last couple of weeks, it has really overgrown beautifully. And look at that female Black Molly. She is huge. And what I love about it is that there's so much protection in here. The growth is so thick that any babies born have a good chance of survival. Brings back a memory. Back when I was a kid, it was a neighbor who had a long 20-gallon tank that was filled with Anacris. And it was just totally amazing how you could watch the fish come out of the hidden area of the heavy plantings. A fascinating tank to just watch at. I was always amazed. And this is very similar to that now. Just very pleased with all this growth. I've got to get in there and clean it up. But look at that female Molly. She looks like she could give 50 babies at a drop. I put the female swordtails in here because they're pregnant and hopefully they'll drop their young. But so far, not happening. Not happening. Obviously, I have to clean this tank up and reorganize those plants. But for right now, I think this tank is perfect as far as a breeding tank goes. There's one of those swordtails. And I showed you before, I tried putting them in that little maternity tank, and they will not drop babies there. I don't know why not. And I hope by having them in here, they've been in here about 3 weeks now, and they haven't done it. So not sure what that's about. Sometimes when I do a water change, that'll trigger the birthing. So later today, I'm going to try that and see what happens. You see on the glass there, the Otacinclus catfish that I've added to each of the tanks. And so he's keeping the glass in here pretty well clean of algae. And there's two or three others. Each tank has about four. You can see some of the baby black mollies in here. There's a couple. But not as many as I would have expected, given the size of some of these very pregnant females. Anyway, that's the office tank today. I'll try and show it to you after I organize those plants sometime soon, okay? Until then. Okay, I did take my time here and took out all the plants and then put them back in. And half of them went into the bow tank in the living room. And you can see what a difference it made here. Now, of course, you do have the concern what happened to the idea of the babies being protected by all the greenery in here. But so be it. I took out at least a dozen swordtails of various sizes. But look at that female Black Molly. I don't know if I can capture her for you. Does she look like she's ready to drop? Beautiful lyre tail on her. And not happening. Although we do see some babies in here. And hopefully there's plenty of kabamba. And again, that other plant, I'm going to have to figure out what that other plant is. I'm tired of just calling it the other plant. Protect the babies in. There's actually an Amazon sword plant buried right dead center past that rock wall. And these are baby Amazon swords from that mother plant. And everybody seems to be happy. We'll change the water tonight. That sometimes induces some birthing. We shall see. But looks a little bit different, doesn't it? I'm very pleased. I really am. I have a lot of good times with this. And I appreciate your comments. So, until next time. Whoops, sorry about that. Damn this tripod. I gotta get rid of this damn thing. All right. You take care, right?